wing. Pass was broken up. And then cut down was Landeskog. He goes into Riddick, and now we've got a ton of pushing and shoving. Landeskog still on one knee. Rantanen is having a quick conversation with Ekholm back behind the net, and he's getting angry, and Ekholm's getting a piece of him. He's yanking on his lid and tore his helmet off. Did Ekholm and threw it. And now here comes Makar, and Kadri's involved. Mikko is red hot, and now he may have a fight. Landeskog is going to go toe-to-toe with Ekholm, a couple of rights. Landeskog leveling Ekholm, and he pounds him down to the ice. Other bodies getting into it on the near side. Goodness gracious, and Ekholm is bloodied. They're still tied up on the near side.
Well, Ekholm and Rantanen had a little something going earlier. Now, Landeskog was tripped down and slid into the goaltender. You can't blame Riddick, he's going to get mad. But then all of a sudden, all of this started.
Landeskog saw out Ekholm and bloodied him. Wow.
When you watch the replay, you're going to see Gabe Landeskog under no way was he meaning to dive into the goaltender. He just goes down. Well, Riddick's going to get upset. You can hit
him. Of course,
he is.
Absolutely.
Sure. Now Ekholm rips the helmet off right here. There was something going on earlier because of this. Now off comes the helmet.
Then he threw it.
And now here comes Gabe Landeskog, and Ekholm just wasn't ready for this.
Not at all.
Yeah. And Moj, you and I, you know, we've been around the Avalanche. Gabe Landeskog's a big man.
He's strong.
And strong as a bull. There is that ability to punch, and there's ability to, you know, the man can throw a punch.
Here's McDermott. He says, I like it.
Yeah, but what's going to happen here now will be really important inside of this game, because the Avalanche had a chance on the power play. Landeskog went to the locker room because he knew he had 5 minutes.
Right.
And he looked up at the clock, and what is there remaining? 2:07. So that was a done deal.
Well, let the officials figure this out. Again, Mikko Rantanen, when Ekholm grabbed his helmet, he grabbed right at the ear, took it off, and then he threw it around the glass, and it ricocheted like a curling rock all the way up toward the blue line.
But is the referee going to say that Ekholm and Rantanen were involved, and Landeskog came in and got involved in that?
Well, we'll see. Kyle Raymond and Tom Cimolinski are the referees here tonight. The linesmen are Caleb Apperson and Ryan Gibbons.
I'm watching body language, and EJ is way more unhappy than Yossi. So something's going against the Avalanche here.
Let's take a look one more time.
Again, Landeskog, he's following the puck, he falls through. Riddick gives him a little shot, like you're going to, the guy runs into you.
That's natural.
That's natural. And then there's pushing and shoving. Guys in and around your goaltender. But then Ekholm and Rantanen, who I said, a couple of times they've whacked at each other in neutral ice where there was no reason.
And Kyle Raymond over having a conversation with Jared Bednar. He's trying to explain his side of things.
See, I'm seeing five. I'm not sure Ekholm's getting anything.
Let's take a look one more time.
I mean,
here comes the helmet. You'll see it be thrown by Ekholm around the boards. And Landeskog comes in on Ekholm. Now, they were tied up with each other right there. The lids come off, and then this is where it all begins.
But does Ekholm throw a punch? Does he, you know, what does he do?
Well, he was helpless.
Yeah.
He's getting ragdolled by Landeskog.
Not helpless, but I mean, he
Well,
was.
You know what I mean. He's getting ragdolled. It's going to be